of justice function.
But tomorrow, the ban on the appointment of losing candidates ends. Well, today it ends, and tomorrow the appointments can be made. Who else are you expecting? Give us a bit of a scoop here. Who else are you expecting among your party mates who's going to get a post?
Well, I think it's a given also that many of those who've been stalwarts of the party, Governor Grace Padaca, Governor Among Ed Panlilio, Governor Vic Agbayani. These are, if not immediately, they surely or expectedly will be in the horizon or the radar of what are the possible new faces. And they have more than enough. It's not just because they're party mates, Gigi. They have truly experience, competence. And I think, not to brag, but the Liberal Party has a deep bench.
Looks like
of real, you know, committed leaders who could really contribute to help this president.
It looks like Senator Mar Rojas. It's been announced by the president may get the position of presidential chief advisor. What are your thoughts on that? I mean, he's from being the vice presidential candidate and then taking on a position.
I think this is going to be, as the president himself said in Jakarta, Gigi, this is going to be a redefining, perhaps, of responsibilities here. Even perhaps the very name itself or the designation of what kind of authorities come with that and the mandate. But I think it's very clear, and the president has said it in Jakarta, that former Senator Mar Rojas is going to be very critical and will play that very critical role in the whole decision making, the whole filtering, clearing of all of what comes onto the president's desk day in and day out, right?
But isn't there going to be any friction between him and, say, the executive secretary?
Well, you know, we trust the president. He's able to, if there's anything I think that people will increasingly find out, the president knows how to balance.
I mean, let's talk about the white elephant in the room, the factions in the cabinet. Really, do you think that maybe this will exacerbate the situation?
You know, it might even be the beginning, Gigi, of some convergence. Maybe not exactly, you know, a deepening of the rifts, or if you call them that, or the divides. I think it will even be the beginning of, because there will be, you'd be surprised, but during the campaign last year, and it's exactly been a year to the day, right, when we had the May 10 elections, there was really, you could sense that with the volunteers, the Liberal Party, the different networks, the local support systems all over the country, there was really there was solidarity. And I think it's just been heightened after June 30, you know, with media saying talagang nagkakahiwa-hiwalay, talagang may mga faction. But really, leading up to the campaign, there was more of that sense of solidarity. And if we were clear about what we were fighting for, and if that can come back with this post 1 year and the post ban, then all the better.
What are you going to be leaving behind when you take over as DENR secretary? I mean, what have you been busy with that you're going to be leaving behind before you?
It will still, Gigi, will not be exactly leaving behind, because we will still continue to work with all of what we've always been a part of. It's sort of our home, the Liberal Party. I'm Secretary General of the Council of Asian Liberals and Democrats. And for the very first time in Asia, what you call the Liberal International, which is a gathering, which is a whole sort of grouping of all the liberal parties around the world, will have its first ever Congress here held in Asia because of this Liberal Party president in power. And so while it's not government or state-to-state event, it's going to be a real global liberal parties, even. There'll be former ministers, former heads of state coming. And we have even a roadmap to Manila, a road to Manila to the Congress in June.
Okay.
I'm plugging this in. So we've been working on this.
Well, we wish you good luck as you,
as
you start your new job.
We're still playing coy here, right?
I don't know. I don't know what the point of that is. But we wish you luck and
thank you
for joining us
this evening. All the best also.
We'll tell you all about the cyber buzz on appointments when Strictly Politics returns. Stay with us.